It's good to have you join us on today's episode of the program Environment and You on Independent Television Abuja. I am your host, Catherine Eyemese, and I say welcome to the program. Today we shall be taking a look at the topic genetically modified crops and food security. The role of genetically modified crops for food security has remained a subject of public controversy, but should this be an option at a time like this when the world is facing food shortage due to one reason or the other, especially in Nigeria? How safe are these genetically modified crops for consumption? I have with me a guest in the house, in the person of Mr. Opua Abikwen. Yeah. Am I right?
Correct.
He is a scientist, and he will be doing justice to the topic of discussion today. I welcome you to the program.
Welcome, viewers. Good afternoon.
All right, to start with, when we talk about genetically modified crops or genetically modified organisms, what should we expect? What are we talking about?
Okay, we are talking about crops whose genes has been enhanced to make them withstand some the most common threats we have today in facing our agriculture and food systems. Example of challenges like pests and disease of crop plants, drought brought about by climate change. So these are issues that conventional breeding practices, conventional agricultural practices have not been able to handle.
Okay.
That's why scientists are seeking the option of enabling plant genes with genes of interest from other living things to make these plants be able to withstand these changes that we experience in
our agriculture system. All right, when you talk about enhancing crops, what process do they undergo?
They undergo a process of genetic modification.
Okay.
And that process is simply taking a gene of interest from another living thing and inserting it into these crop plants. Okay. So that gene of interest, the protein it codes in this other organism that is found of interest, is now being expressed by this new organism where it is introduced to.
Okay.
So that's what happens. So that's just a simple process of genetic modification.
From what I have seen so far, from some videos that I have seen online, I see scientists injecting some substances into some crops. What is that substance and how safe is it?
That's totally not related to genetic modification.
Okay.
That's not a process. That's not, those images don't represent genetic modification. But there are images put out there by those that oppose the technology. I'll just say those that have a different perspective about the technology, that want to sell fear out. So when those images are there like that, you look at them like that, you start feeling, okay, these things are really bad. Why would they be injecting something into plants? So that's totally a misrepresentation of what genetic modification is.
Okay.
Yeah.
So can you tell us how safe is genetically modified and food? How safe is it for human consumption?
It is very safe. I've consumed them when I was in the US. In fact, when I go to the shop to buy groceries, I go for genetically modified foods because they are cheaper. And as someone who cares about the environment, I see that genetically modified foods will contribute more to the safety of the environment by cutting down greenhouse gas emissions. So it's not just about the price. And apart from me knowing that there's overwhelming consensus about the safety of genetically modified crops by reputable organizations, including the Academy of Sciences.
Okay.
And back home here, like every country has their own regulatory bodies. Like in Nigeria, we have the National Biosafety Management Agency responsible for regulating this technology and these products. And before, after the National Biosafety Management Agency, you still have agencies like NAFDAC.
Okay.
So I think genetically modified foods are the safest foods to even consume because they are more regulated than any other type of foods in the market.
How do we recognize genetically modified foods from the conventional ones we see and buy in the market?
Okay, in the Nigeria biosafety law, there's provision that genetically modified foods will be labeled.
Okay.
Just like it is in some states in the US.
Okay.
So consumers are free to make their choice on consuming genetically modified or
Okay.
They are
labeled in the market, and yes. when you want to get some, you can easily get them. Okay. Well, what is the relationship between GMOs and the environment?
Okay. The relationship between GMOs and the environment is that, first of all, we know the environment, most importantly, crop plants, cash crops, all those kind of plants affect the environment in different ways.
Okay.
For instance, now GMOs, what GMOs will do to the environment is that it will reduce the emission of greenhouse gases,
okay,
thereby reducing climate change. Hmm. So even stakeholders in the climate change sector have advocated for the use of biotechnology crops to see how we can cut down greenhouse gas emissions. In the past, it was not an issue. Nobody knew that plants were contributing lots of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. But of recent,
I was going to ask how does that contribute? Emission.
Okay, so the more the expanse of land where we cultivate crops, where we have plants, the more they emit, because plants have to make their food.
Okay.
So biotechnology will use less land to produce more.
Hmm.
So instead of emitting more greenhouse gases, it will cut down the level of emission of greenhouse gases.
Okay.
So that's what biotechnology is about.
All right. Yeah. The program is Environment and You on Independent Television Abuja, and is being our guest, a scientist, doing justice to the topic of discussion, which is genetically modified crops and food security. We'll quickly go on a short break, and when we come back, the program continues. Stay tuned. Welcome back. Before we went on that break, we told you that the topic of discussion is genetically modified crops and food security, and we are talking about how safe GMOs is for human consumption. And we also talked about the fact that GMOs reduces gas emission in the environment. And moving on, Mr. Okua. Right?
Yes.
All right. Moving on, what do we say that, how can, genetically modified crops, does it have to do with all kinds of crops, or they are ones that they can be grown scientifically, or any kind of crops at all?
Okay, so the fact is that every nation has its peculiarities and its problems that are peculiar to them.
Mm.
So if another country is growing GM canola, it doesn't mean Nigerians consume canola. So we look at what is important to us.
Okay.
So it's context-based.
Mm.
So any country can decide to grow whatever crop.
All right. Modify Nigeria, any crop. In Nigeria, we grow
In Nigeria, we have cowpea for food crop and cotton for cash crop.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Thank you very much for that insight. Mm. And going forward, what are the advantages? What advantages does GMO possesses against the other kind of crops in the markets?
Okay, we've been talking benefits. I can just go on. For instance, I was reading a report some days ago about the GM cowpea, the present GM cowpea in Nigeria. Farmers have come out to testify after the first growing season that this variety has cut down pesticide use.
Okay.
Enormously. And the quantity of cost of pesticides cut down will save farmers about 16 billion naira yearly in Nigeria.
Hmm.
While these have also increased the yield by 25%.
Hmm.
So that's one of the benefits. It will increase yield, cut down pesticide use. And when it cuts down pesticide use, it's good for me and you, it's good for the environment. Because these farmers, if you've ever been to a cowpea field, you see that these farmers spray almost every week to keep this pest out of their crops.
Okay.
And that's toxic to their health. you have most of the residue of these pesticides on the cowpea, okay, on the beans.
All right.
So that even when they harvest and bring to the market, we consume the pesticide residues, which is not good to our health.
Mm.
So GM cowpea will take away pesticide use and will also increase the yield.
Mm.
And that's economic benefits.
Okay.
That's economic benefits. If you talk about the socio-economic aspect, you see that we will now start exporting cowpea.
Mm.
We are the largest producers in West Africa and Africa, but we are still importing,
okay,
because we consume it a lot.
Mm.
We consume about 3.6 metric tons of cowpea yearly, and we produce just 3.1
right.
million. So we import 500,000 metric tons. But with this 25% increase in yield, we will even start exporting.
Mm.
And it is estimated that Nigeria will make 46 billion naira yearly in export of cowpea.
All right. Do we also use fertilizers
in
growing GMOs, genetically modified crops?
Yes, they can use fertilizers.
Fertilizer is encouraged.
Yes, yeah? Fertilizer is encouraged. What this trait is about is tackling the insects.
Okay.
Tackling the insects.
Okay.
So by the time the insects are tackled, you might not even really need to use fertilizer.
Okay.
Because the insects already reduce their yield.
Mm.
So by the time they are free from insects, you might discover that, okay, there's no need for fertilizer.
Mm.
So it will even cut down the use of fertilizers greatly,
okay,
on farmers' fields.
All right. It is also said that there are two sides to every coin. Whatever has an advantage also has a disadvantage. So what are the negative impact of GMOs? Do we have any?
I see no negative impact with GMOs, because just like our foods, our conventional foods, there are no negative impacts about them.
Okay.
Instead, I see that GMOs will help replenish the environment, cut down greenhouse gas emissions.
Okay.
That's even an advantage that our conventional food, which we've not seen a disadvantage in, won't even do.
Okay.
So I feel there are no disadvantages with GMOs.
Okay.
I don't feel that there are any.
All right, for the sake of viewers out there and for the sake of those who has negative thoughts or misconception concerning GMO, now, you made mention of a government agency in charge of regulations when it comes to GMO. What are these regulations for people who have misconception to have it at the back of their mind?
Okay, it's a whole lot of process,
okay,
that goes through. And when people have this misconception, they just feel GMOs are something that you just start modifying today and tomorrow is in the market. It doesn't go like, it doesn't happen like that. There are various stages of research. The agency will first even give approval to the scientists who want to carry out this research to even start. In fact, there are some research work that students do for their project in school relating to this technology, not for even public consumption, that they must get approval from this agency to carry out such research. So some GM crops like this cowpea now, it's not a project that started today.
Mm.
It has gone through various scrutiny from the agencies. You filed for this application, they go through it, they see that, okay, it meets the requirements before they approve. It gets to the extent where it comes to the public, for the public to have inputs too. So it's not as if it's something that the agency and the developer just stay and do. The public also have a stake. It comes to a point where they do public hearing, submit your application. Why do you think this should not be approved?
Okay.
You understand?
Mm.
And all that. So there are stages. It goes through a lot of processes before it gets to the market, before it gets to the farmers and consumers.
All right. Let's, looking at the state of insecurity in the country, Nigeria, today, and shortage of food, coupled with farmers, herders, clashes in some parts of the country, would you say GMO, growing of GMO crops, is the way to go?
Even without the farmers, herder clashes, the insecurity, we are experiencing changing weather patterns. Like for me, for instance, there are crops that they used to grow in my locality that nobody grows again, that they are neglected because they don't do well anymore.
Okay.
We have those challenges here. The farmer herder clashes is not the cause of pests on beans that they are genetically modifying. So this will just help us to overcome all these challenges.
Mm.
So we had challenges there before, then we have these other challenges now. So anybody who says GMOs is not the way to go, it means you don't like the rural poor, okay, because they are the ones who will benefit more from this technology. Okay. Right. It's not those who sit in big offices in Abuja and say the technology is not good. No, all they're right, not the ones.
All right, we'll go on a short break. When we come back, the program Environment and You continues shortly. Stay with us. Welcome to the program Environment and You on Independent Television Abuja, and it's been genetically modified organism and food security. That is the topic of discussion that we are doing justice to in the studio today. And before we went on that break, it's been a scientist in this area and doing justice to the topic of discussion. And to wrap up the program, there are many misconceptions concerning GMO crops. Now, can you dwell more on that before we wrap up the program for today?
Okay, so Yes, there's several misinformation out there about the technology, and I don't want to say those spreading this misinformation are opponents of the technology. I would rather say they have a different perspective about the technology, which can change, which certainly can change. Somebody who is opposing, who has a different perspective about the technology today might have a different perspective tomorrow. So like these images you are seeing here, it has no, they don't represent GM technology. It's just like kids playing and picking up fruits and injecting things into them. This has nothing to do with genetic modification. This is totally not the process. This is totally not the process. So this is a misrepresentation. And why they do this is to create fear in people about the technology. And the technology is nothing to fear. Like I said, I have consumed GMOs.
Okay.
Even the agency responsible for promoting the technology, when they harvested the first GM cowpea beans, they made akara with them.
Hmm.
And they invited members of the public. And they ate them. People ate them.
Okay.
They ate them. So this is a misrepresentation. And I think this shouldn't really be used to make opinions about this technology. And again, I would like to inform members of the public that whenever they see things about the technology, if they want to get to the facts about them, the source matters.
Mm.
Because anybody can go on the internet and make these pictures and put there.
Okay.
There are experts, there are agencies that can handle these questions. They are open. They have their Facebook pages. They have their phone numbers. You could call and ask questions about these things, and not to dwell on misinformation from people who are not even in any way doing anything related to this sector.
All right. Yeah. All right. That is the size. Size of our package today on the program Environment and You on Independent Television Abuja. Next week is another day for another interesting package of the program. Join us again same time next week. And before we wrap up, I must appreciate you for being on the program today.
Thank you very much.
Your host, Catherine Eyemese. Bye for now.